Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. Anda bersama Daddy Joe Cover Story. Untuk video klip kali ini saya akan berikan untuk anda sebuah rancangan temu bual BBC bersama seorang penulis warga British dan juga seorang saintis pada 1964. Bagaimana beliau telah meramalkan teknologi moden yang akan digunakan dua dekad selepas tahun 1964 itu. Dan pada hari ini, ramalan-ramalan beliau ini telah menjadi kenyataan dan digunakan oleh masyarakat masa kini. Okey, saksikan untuk anda berklik yang amat menarik ini.
But what about the city of the day after tomorrow? Say, the year 2000. I think it will be completely different. In fact, it may not even exist at all. Oh, I'm not thinking of the atom bomb and the next stone age. I'm thinking of the incredible breakthrough which has been made possible by developments in communications, particularly the transistor and, above all, the communication satellite. These things will make possible a world in which we can be in instant contact with each other wherever we may be, where we can contact our friends anywhere on Earth, even if we don't know their actual physical location. It will be possible in that age, perhaps only 50 years from now, for a man to conduct his business from Tahiti or Bali just as well as he could from London. In fact, if it proves worthwhile, almost any executive skill, any administrative skill, even any physical skill, could be made independent of distance. I am perfectly serious when I suggest that one day we may have brain surgeons in Edinburgh operating on patients in New Zealand. When that time comes, the whole world will have shrunk to a point, and the traditional role of the city as a meeting place for man would have ceased to make any sense. In fact, men will no longer commute, they will communicate. They won't have to travel for business anymore, they'll only travel for pleasure. I only hope that when that day comes, and when the city is abolished, the whole world isn't turned into one giant suburb.